Hey, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to another Let's Build episode. Today we're bringing the modern house back, so we're going to start with a base structure like this, and then eventually we're going to fortify it with a covenant style defense system and add a whole bunch of new features from the Wasteland Workshop DLC. So before we start building, let's just have a quick little sneak peek. We're going to start with a modern layout, and then we're going to add a nice defense system to it. Okay, all the way around, and a nice little tower at the entrance. We're going to build a decontamination sort of section at the front entrance of the house, and then we're just going to go ahead, we're going to add a few little cosmetic touches, okay? Stuff like the linen closet over here, and even though it's pointless, I like to build the immersion in most of my builds, so whether it's relevant or not, we're just going to add a few little touches like that. We've got our kitchen here, we've got the living area, dining area, and over to our left here we have the bar. Okay, this is like a built-in bar with a side access around the side of the house. Like I'm sure most of us are aware, it is important to have a bar in your settlement. Okay, so for the smaller settlements like this and you want to build something small, you can build something like this and just ensure that you have, you know, enough leisure areas, places with chairs, radios, you know, just stuff like that. I boxed my fusion generator in once again. Now this is just to keep the modern layout kind of theme. I've done the same thing to the water pump. Of course the rad pool is back once again. We got a water pump here which I've tweaked up just a little bit, so it just looks a little bit more realistic. We're going to make sure all of our resources are covered, so we're going to go ahead and build ourselves a nice little man-made cropping area around the side here, which as you can see still needs a little bit of attention. I haven't fully decorated yet or anything like that. We got some nice Commonwealth views right here. Even a giant boss airship hovering in the distance. If we go upstairs, you see that we have another entrance just here, which also gives you access to the cropping area and the side door. If we go back inside, we're going to see that we have a nice little center area here which separates all three bedrooms and the bathroom. Kind of irrelevant once again, but all of this stuff does add to the overall settlement happiness. So, I mean, realistically, you probably just build a giant room and put every single settlement item into it and everyone would be happy. But if you want to do it with a little bit of style and keep the immersion in the settlement, then this is pretty much what you're going to have to do, is go ahead and build an actual three-bedroom home or something similar. So this is the modern house 2.0. A few people did ask me about building a new one, and so I thought I'd use this as an opportunity to just help you guys. A few tips and tricks and just one method of building a nice house in Fallout. So with that said, let's just go ahead and let's get started. Okay, so first I'm just going to apologize to little Jimmy's parents who decided they were just going to take the settlement for themselves. Okay, bad move guys. Don't know where little Jimmy ran off to, but I'm sure it'll be fine. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna start off with a 7x5 base, okay? So that's 7 from side to side and 5 from front to back. So we're gonna try and build things as kind of square as we can, okay? You don't wanna get too carried away with the new concrete prefabs, otherwise what you're gonna find is when you go to put your ceiling in, things are just gonna get crazy. So I'll put my wall in here and I'm putting a door in the middle, and then what I'm going to do is start building my front fascia just here. So it's just a protruding wall to add to the modern layout. Okay, so one of the cool new things about the new concrete prefabs is that you can pretty much snap any concrete prefab to a certain point on any prefab. So you got to kind of picture these walls as, like, the smaller ones here are like 4 different parts. So you have 4 different sections on the face that you can snap another concrete prefab to. As a positive, this gives us endless building possibilities, okay, but it comes at a price, of course, which is a very tedious snapping kind of system, because one problem we have is we have one prefab trying to snap to maybe 10 different other sections. So this is why you get that moving back and forth and things not snapping where you want them to go. So this is where I tend to like using guides, okay, which I use even well before the Wasteland Workshop DLC. So what I've done here is I've built my, I'm bringing the feature wall back once again, because, you know, you do see it a lot on modern houses and stuff like that, and it also creates a kind of new window system from the inside, which I'll show you shortly. So we're gonna put that one there. That's just gonna be our electrical box. Now we're gonna build this up a little bit. Okay, so this is our feature wall. We're just gonna put a normal wall in here. And then we're just gonna mimic the same prefabs on top. Okay, so just placing these around. We're gonna work our way around the house here. And we're gonna place this one in like the bottom. So up here, we're just gonna put a bigger piece here because this is gonna protrude out the top here and be just another kind of small balcony adding on to another bedroom. Keeping in mind that we're leaving the right amount of space to put a couple of small floors in there. Now this is something you really need to think about when building with these concrete prefabs, is that you have enough space to put your floors in or your ceiling. And sometimes you're gonna have trouble putting prefabs in like this, so this is where what I talked about earlier about putting guides in order to snap other prefabs to pretty much just where you want them. So as you can see here, I have the right amount of space for the floor, okay? But what I'm gonna need to do is actually take this wall out, because you can't actually put floors in under walls, but you can put walls over floors. And I find it easier just to move the prefab and then just put it back in. It's just a little easier than going back through your inventory and selecting the same prefab again. Just find it a little bit quicker. Now we're gonna just take our other floors out. We're gonna put some more wooden floors in, and we're just gonna work our way around. Now putting the roof or ceiling or whatever it is in first, just lets you know where you need to move your walls around in order for things to be flush. So as you can see here, I've got just a little bit of space between my small floors here. So what I'm gonna have to do is actually pull these walls back just a touch, which is fine because I can just add a smaller wall in here. Okay, so I'm gonna use this as a guide, but we're gonna actually take those other two out. So if we pull these back a little bit and we just go ahead and take these out and then just put a smaller wall in, we can bring our wall back a little bit. So I'm just gonna head up top, put another wall back in here, and then I can just pull this back a touch. Okay, and that gets us pretty flush to the ceiling. So now we can just go along and finish this off. You're probably just gonna have to move stuff around here and there. Now I just go around and just turn all of my floorboards around so they're all facing the same way. We're gonna go around the left side of the house and we're gonna keep building this left side using just the plain walls for now. Go to about here and then we're just gonna check on the other side, because we're flush up on this side, but on this side we're not. Okay, so what we're gonna have to do here is actually just move it out a touch, okay? So it's gonna have to come back and it's gonna have to go out a little bit. So the way we can do this is take this round cornered section off just here, okay? And we're gonna move this out just one pillar width. Okay, we're gonna put one more on the other side. And then, of course, you're gonna have to put new foundations across the side here, but now if we run our corner wall out, that should get us the width, but we're gonna need to pull it back just a touch as well. So just pull this back just one notch and that should get us pretty flush right there. So we can put a round section in here and we can just finish off the rest of our ceiling up here by just taking that wall out, and we have to take the other one out as well. And we should be able to place our floor in just perfectly. So the thing I notice here is we're actually gonna have a balcony here, so we're going to take that out and we're just gonna run a normal floor just through the side here. And once the next one's in, they're gonna go back up top and we're just gonna put this wall back in, okay? And that should just fit in nice and flush. So now we're just gonna finish off this balcony area. So we're gonna just pull this out one small block. And the problem we're gonna have here is that they're not gonna be sitting where we want them to. So we're gonna pull them back to where we are here. We're gonna take this wall out once again. And the other one next to it, just so we can just move that around so it's in line with the other floorboards. And then we'll place our walls back in. And it's pretty flush to me. So So now we're going to put our railings in. And run these across. But then you're going to take that wall out even once more. This will be the last time, I assure you. And then that's just going to just basically butt it right up against the wall. So run our railings around. And then now we're going to pull this front section back a little bit. Okay, this is on the front left side. We're going to just pull our wall over a little bit because we're going to try and get this side wall pretty flush with the floor above it. So it should just snap in like so. We go up the top here and we're going to pretty much do what I said earlier about using a guide in order to snap something where you want it to snap. So we're going to use the smaller wall there just to run it along, and then just going to run this way. That way we can just pull this other wall straight over. Finish off this side wall just here, and then we're going to go back up the top and we're just going to take these few prefabs out and just put a half block in here. This is going to give us about a small floor width between both walls, so it's going to be handy when we go to put railings in. Now over the back, we're going to just finish this back wall off here. So just for now, I'm going to put a couple of pillar pieces in here, and then I'm just going to run a wall along the back side here. So we're just going to snap them in like so. We're then going to start putting the bottom wall in, which is actually going to be a little further in towards the house. This is going to give us a little bit of a bulkhead at the very back here. We'll put some more floors in, and then we're just going to run our walls around like we did before. I know this can get a little tedious after a while, okay, but if you want to build complex structures, then this is just something you have to put up with. So we're going to just move this wall back. We can do this by placing our walls in the side here and just giving ourselves a little bit of a guide to snap our walls too. So run these all the way along, and then we're going to go around the back and we're going to start working on the design on the back wall. Okay, now this is just like a protruding sort of wall design that goes around the back. You see it on a lot of modern houses these days. I think it's mainly just to block out stuff like light and stuff like that, or then again it might be just a cosmetic feature. Either way, we're putting one on ours, and all you really want to do is just run almost flush with the electrical box around the side here. Okay, now I know a window goes in here, so I'm gonna put one just up the top. And then to finish off our wall, we just add a couple of small walls in the sides here and one around the other side as well. First, we're just gonna start on our feature wall here. So I use the pillars, and you just wanna put two in the middle, and then you just wanna leave one space between either side, okay? You put more up the top, and then we'll come back to this. So you just wanna go to your back wall here. With this is the living room. We're just gonna put a couple of screens in here. You can put windows, of course. I think the screens come up really nice and give you a good view from the inside. So we're gonna take this floor out. We're gonna put our stairs in here. And then now we're gonna finish off our back wall. So we're just gonna move this into place. And we're just gonna use walls for now. Like I said, we can always put windows in later on. It's no fuss. So then we can now run our wall off the back here once it snaps. And that's about where we want to sit. So we'll put our small wall in just here. Should be able to, yep, that looks pretty good to me. And now we're gonna go around the back here, we're gonna put our back wall in. So we're gonna throw a few more of these normal size walls in, and then we're gonna have to actually change its path here. So, yeah. So I'm gonna take that one out, and we might just bring it in about here. Okay, because we're gonna have our stairwell there anyway, so we're gonna need to block that off eventually. So we're gonna run these along, and we're gonna have a small gap here, so we can just put another little pillar piece in the middle just to finish that off. Now we're going to place the stairway on the left side because it won't actually go in the right side there. I'll finish our wall off. So this is going to be a bit of a balcony section, so we're just going to run this wall across here, and then give ourselves a little bit of a doorway, say about here somewhere. And if we snap the door to the very corner here, we should allow ourselves enough room to just take this out and put a big wall in, which fits quite nice. Okay, it's gonna finish off our floors here. Down in the bar area, we're gonna start building our outdoor patio sort of area. Okay, so in order to do this, we're going to just place walls in here. Otherwise, this is just going to help us out when we go to put our floors in, and we're gonna have the right amount of width and space between the walls. So I'm gonna use my walls up the top here to pretty much use as a guide for underneath. Okay, you can see how they just pop over. And we're just gonna fit one more in. And now what we need to do is create ourselves a couple of little gaps in the middle here. Okay, because it has to be sort of opened up, but not too opened up. Eventually we're gonna put another screen here anyway, so it's not a big deal at the moment. I'm just gonna put stairs in up here because now we're just gonna put our doorway in. Okay, this is just gonna go down to the back pool area and our back section of the balcony. Now we're gonna kinda seal this off a little bit from the living and dining area. So I'm just gonna use a half piece here and a half piece there. Okay, we're gonna run this across because our linen closet's gonna be here somewhere. I mean, it's not necessarily a linen closet, but you know, you can't put stuff on the shelves and stuff like that. It might come in handy, come survival mode. Either way, it's just a little cosmetic kind of idea that just adds to the modern theme. So if I put a door piece just in here, I could just move this wall forward a little bit. It's gonna leave us a one space gap where I can just put in a couple of pillar pieces to the side here, just wherever they fit, and then I can just sort of push them over to the side a bit more. So I'm gonna finish off this feature wall out the back here by snapping a floor and roof prefab. We're gonna finish off the stairs. Okay, so I'm just gonna put a wall in there to use as a guide, a small piece, a bigger piece, and then we're just gonna put a wall over the other side here to kind of confine the stairs a little bit. Okay, so we can finish this by just putting a half piece in the front here. And then finally, just a wall here to kind of separate the living and dining area from the main entrance. So I'm gonna put a half wall up the front here. Take this middle bit out. So go up the top, we're gonna start putting our ceiling in. So we do this by taking this back wall out, and then we're gonna put a floor and roof prefab in. Okay, this is our guide once again. We're gonna put a normal floor in, take that out, put our wall back in, and then now we should just be able to run our floors all the way around. So just go ahead, fill the entire volume of the upper floor. You can have spaces like this, don't stress too much about it. We're gonna fix them up very shortly. Now, all we want to do is put some small floors in here as well, much like we did just below, and run these all the way across. Once that's done, we're just going to get access to the roof, so we're going to put an actual extra layer on top of the original ceiling. But first, we're just going to finish off this feature wall. Now, we're going to run that all the way around to where it needs to go to. Finish off the ones at the front, and what you're gonna find is that you have a little bit of a problem right here. That's okay, it's just gonna be a little bit of a pain in the ass. So we're gonna put these two on like that. We're gonna go around the other side here, and we're just gonna run this maybe two small floors across, and that actually gets pretty close. So I'm gonna put a sky roof, or I don't know what you'd call it, skylight maybe, just in the top here. Give us a little bit of light through the second floor. We're gonna start building our rooms now. So I've just ran mine off the stair line and this one off the window line just here. So we're gonna run that two out, and then we should be able to use a half piece in here. Just get us pretty flush. Yeah, looks pretty good. Okay, just so our bedroom doors here are parallel to each other. So put one there, one here. We're gonna have our bathroom right here, so I'm probably just gonna use a couple of these pillars as a guide. We're gonna throw our door in. Okay, we got the rough shape of the center room here. So now we're just gonna put some walls in here to block off the bathroom section, and yeah, it might actually have a pillar either side, which works pretty well. So we do this both sides, and then now what we're going to do is take that out for a window, but we're going to go over to the third room at the front, and we're going to put a door near the balcony. It's not really much of a balcony, but that's what I'm going to call it. So we're just going to put a door at the front here. This is our center area just upstairs. Okay, so we're going to try and get that flush along, and now we've got pretty much the base structure of the house. So we just got a few little finishing touches. I'm going to block this stairs off. We're going to go back around to the right side of the house where the side access stairwell is, and we're going to put just a couple more foundations in, okay, because this is going to be our cropping area, so we're going to need to just extend it a little bit. Now we're going to use my dropping technique, where we just use a floor and stairs prefab, a wooden prefab, to drop a prefab down flat on the ground. So this just basically makes it drop perfectly square, so we can run the rest of our floors off it. So once we've dropped that down, we're going to get rid of the unnecessary ones. We're going to put two floors in the middle here. We're going to take that one out actually. And then we're just going to put a couple of small floors at the far end. Now, what we'll do is just get rid of these unnecessary ones here. We're going to put some man-made gardens in here for cropping. So first, just going to create a little bit of a garden sort of area using the wooden rails. I'm going to place these down like so. Now I'm going to just finish it off by just putting a few more around the outside here and all the way down the back of the house. So just run these all the way to where the stairs is going to be, I guess. We're going to go around the front and we're going to finish off this feature wall. So how I do this is I line this up as center as I can to the first two pillars, and I just move it back a little bit, okay, because once I place these back in, the concrete's not going to have a problem. So I just run these all the way up and do the same thing with the top. And straight back in, and you should end up with something like this, using the smaller ones for the left and right. Okay, we're going to put two more little small floors up here, and then we go inside, just put a door out near the staircase, and then we're going to go back up top, and now we're going to do the dropping technique again, okay, just to get a little extra height on this roof. Just going to run them all the way around. You're going to end up with pretty much one problem at the end here. So what we're going to do is actually do the dropping technique one more last time, and just going to drop him down like so, and then take out the unnecessary ones, and then we're just going to run this all the way back to where our darker small floors are just here. Now I'm just going to drop back down, put that wall back in that I had to take out earlier. Okay, you might not have to do this. So anyway, we're going to move along to the bar area now, and we're going to put our bar in. So this is just lining things up so I can fit a half wall and a pillar in either side. Okay, fits in quite well. We're going to take the stairs out and we're going to start building our little outdoor living area at the side here. So we're going to have to take a few walls out. We're going to run these three across, and then what we're going to do is put some pillars underneath for support. So I'm using a guide here once again. One pillar to the side, take that out, and then put another pillar in there, take the second one out. Do this all the way across. So we place a little platform here for a stairway, and then we're just gonna put some rails in all the way across as well. So we should place these neatly in on the side here. Now, what we're gonna do is we're going to put the electrical box in now. So I just put this in here as a guide. We're gonna place the fusion generator in, okay. Move that over a little bit. We're gonna pretty much get that as close as we can to the wall, and then we're gonna put one in the side here. Okay, concrete is pretty good because it usually goes through a lot of things without going into the red. So a couple of pillars and a screen and we're done. Now put a conduit up the top so we can run that up to the roof, and like I said earlier, concrete's really useful for covering things up, so we should place that in there like so. Now, I place the stairs in like that. It's very hard to place a stairs through a foundation, but if you get the right angle, you can do it. So we're gonna start building our pool area, and we're just gonna run foundations all the way across. We're gonna have about a 3 space for the pool. And then I'm going to do the dropping technique here because I don't like the color of the foundations or the new ones. So I'm then just going to run these across the top. I'll put a couple of the small floors in here. And then we're going to run our rails all the way around, and then we're going to take two out so we can start building our little water pump box thing. So we're just going to box this off by basically using the same method that we used on the fusion generator, okay, just basically building it around it. And then I'm going to go ahead and just put myself a screen or window, whichever you prefer, and then we just run them straight underneath using the top walls as guides. So do the same thing on the front, and then now I'm at a position where I need to, well, I need a little more space, so I'm going to use the build limit glitch. It's just done by dropping weapons on the ground and then storing them in your inventory. Sorry, workshop. So I've done a little bit of decor now, so it's starting to come along pretty nice. I'm just going to put my little turret platform up on the balcony here. I think it's just necessary to have maybe at least one turret inside the perimeter. So we'll just pop a turret on top there and just put a railing in on the side. Straighten them up a little bit and put our shelves in here, our little, I don't know what kind of closet we're going to call it right now. So just want to fill it up like that and then just put a door on. Okay, so now we're on the home stretch, so we're going to start building our fence line. Okay, this is our perimeter. Now, I've just pulled it out off the foundation there, and we're just going to run these along. Now, you can run this out as far as you like, really. Does not really matter. I'm just going to run mine to pretty much in line with the very annoying shed I can't get rid of. So run this around to the other side of the other foundation. Pop them down a little bit. We just run these out to the end as well. And we just keep bringing these back, and then what we're going to do is we're going to snap some more underneath, okay, just to finish it. And it's all the way along. And we're just going to have to put some smaller ones in here. You're going to have the problem of a little gap down the bottom there, but there's heaps of ways you can fix that. So we'll put our curved wall in, we'll pull these back a little bit, and then once you get around to the other side, I've just finished mine by just pulling it out of touch, just past the line of the staircase just here, and pop that in like so. Now, I'm just gonna build this out a little bit. Okay, a bit of a nice little outdoor sitting area around the side here. I'm gonna use wooden prefabs for this bit here. And then now we're just gonna start putting our turret supports up. Okay, so I've just done this by leaving a gap in the middle. Okay, using two little small pillars as guides. And we do this all the way along. And then now we just go pop them in. We put one underneath as well. And then we just go ahead and take these out. Okay, so that's looking pretty good. Now we're just gonna put our little walkway in. So I've just used the floor and roof prefab, and then I snap my small floors to it. We get stairs got the top here. The problem we got here is that our turret ones aren't going to line up properly. So we're just gonna go around, we're gonna finish these off, and then we're just gonna run this around the entire perimeter, okay? Once you've done that, you then wanna just pop down below. We're gonna grab this corner piece here, and we're gonna drop that down, okay? So that way we can just drop the rest of them down and just get them at about the height of the wall, just to give it a better finish. So then we'll just put some rails up. Okay, these will snap in quite easy when they snap to a wall piece. And then now we're gonna put our turret platforms in. So what I do here is I put a wall in, okay? And then I'm just gonna have to take this out and then put a floor and roof prefab in, and then we can start running our line across now that we have the right form. So run these across, and you can see kind of where they land. Take out what's not needed, and then we're just gonna run this all the way across, and we're gonna do this on all walls, okay? So the whole way around. Take this out, and we'll just take the rest out now. And then now we just put our turrets in. Okay, so we're gonna just run these heavy machine gun turrets for now. I have heard bad things about laser turrets, even though they're effective, I guess. I'm gonna try these out just for something different. And a little less worrying, of course. So now we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna build ourselves a bit of a staircase for the walkway. This isn't entirely necessary. It is for me because I built a little tower at the entrance. So I just do this by just building around it, basically. Just line yourself up as best as you can. It doesn't have to look perfect. They're only staircases. And then once that's finished, we're then just gonna go ahead and do the final bit, which is the decontamination section at the entrance, which is very simple. Just using some half blocks on the side here, a door on the front, and a normal wall on top. Okay, of course the top is covered by a couple of floors, so you have two different options here. You can either power it from this wall over to the right side. Okay, by pulling this wall out, we can stick a generator behind there, and then you can just attach that directly to it. Or you could always just power it from the roof to save having wires inside here, and this can be done by just simply taking this one out and putting a I don't know what you call it, a round corner piece just here. Flip that around and then you can just run your wire straight down through by just installing a conduit at the top here. So you can just use a floor conduit first, and then once you get that placed right, you want to place it right near the corner. We're going to go ahead and just place ourselves a wall conduit right there. Okay, so attach that to that. We go down below and then we just attach that directly to it. Now, of course, you're going to have to run power across your roof and everything else. It's going to be pretty easy. All you have to do is put maybe a power pylon in the very center of the roof and then just run conduits to every corner of the house, and you should be able to pretty much power the entire house as well as your decontamination unit at the front. And that's all I got time for, guys. So I really hope you like the design. If you don't like the design, I hope you at least got some ideas here. And if you did, just please don't forget to leave a like for me. Feel free to leave a comment, subscribe if you want more videos. You all have a nice day, and I'll see you guys next time.